After her appointment, Kitty was getting in the van, but she struggled to get in her seat. And she's now stuck on the floor and unable to get up now with the position she's in. And my concern is that the strain of that will lead to her suffering cardiac arrest here soon if we don't get her up. All right, just take a deep breath and breathe normally, okay? Help us coming in, okay?
Whatever, get me out of here.
I know. But it's going to be very difficult to figure out how we lift 700 pounds, especially when she's wedged in between the seats, preventing anyone from being able to reach her. So right now, the only option we can even try will be to get a sheet or a tarp under her to try and pull her out. But we have to get her up soon, before her body starts to reach a breaking point. Where the part is stuck mostly, your right knee?
Oh, right knee, where my foot is stuck.
Okay, right knee and the foot is stuck. Okay, let me go see over there what's going on with that. Her right knee is stuck over here.
Anything that can help her get out?
Can you bring a couple of flat sheets, like what we have? Kelly, I need you to stay calm, okay? If you panic, it's only going to make the situation worse if you start to hyperventilate. That foot is stuck over there. Be careful. Okay, that's great. She's almost there.
Kelly, you okay?
Okay.
You want them to try to set you up now? Okay, ready? Can sit up?
Okay. Watch your foot.
All right, she's out. That's great. I'm going to send her to St. Joseph Hospital to admit her. You feeling okay now? All right, you want to get your feet back in front? Kelly, you doing okay? We'll get you to the hospital and I'll meet you over there, okay? We're gonna take care of you. We're gonna have enough help to get you out of here, okay?
Okay. Okay.
All right. Thankfully, we were able to get Kelly up off the floor before her situation got any worse. But that was a very close call, and Kelly may not be out of the woods yet, because she may still be facing cardiac arrest soon as a result of all the strain that she just put on her whole system. So we need to get her admitted to the hospital immediately. So let's help her to stand up. We got some sheet over there, put under her leg, see if we can help her leg. All right, so let's put this leg on the floor. Bring that bed closer. The head closer, closer. Lock it. I know you're tired, Kelly, but you're gonna have to push yourself a little for us, because it's gonna be far worse on your body if you end up on the ground. We won't be able to lift you up if that happens, so you have to do this.
Okay. Pull me.
Here we go, you're doing good. Pull. Okay, we got her. Just try to look.
Huh?
Watch the arm. Watch the arm.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, great. Let's get her inside. Kitty's weight is so high, it's almost impossible to lift her. But now that we have been able to get her inside and on a bed with a hover mat, we'll be able to move her around like we need, and we can start running tests on her to make sure we identify and address any life-threatening issues she may be experiencing right now. Kitty, you doing okay? We're in the hospital, and we're gonna take care of you, okay? Hopefully, we were able to prevent her body from hitting its limit today. If not, her health could start to decline rapidly here very soon. And we need to move as fast as possible to do everything we can to prevent that. But she's likely going to need to be here for a while because her body has been in severely bad shape for a long time now. And that's not going to be easy to fix and bring her back from. But hopefully, it's not too late for her and we'll be able to do that. We've had Kelly in the hospital for the past week, and we finished running our tests on her, and I'm even more concerned now than I originally was for her, because her results show she's currently experiencing heart failure, and that's been going on for a while now. The heart wasn't designed to be able to sustain a person the size that Kelly is. So when a patient gets over 400, 500, 600 pounds, their heart starts to struggle to pump blood to every part of the body. So it's not a surprise that she's struggling with that. What's concerning is, with how long she's been in this state, her heart is very weak to the point where every heartbeat she has right now is back only a miracle. So we have to alleviate as much strain as we can off her heart by getting her weight down as quickly as possible and upping her aerobic activity to try and strengthen her heart. And it's also gonna be very important that she start working with a cardiologist to see what else can be done to improve her condition. Hi, Kelly.
Hey. How are you?
How are you feeling today?
A lot better.
Great. Well, we finished running all our tests, and our biggest concern is your heart right now. So we're going to keep you here on a controlled diet you've been on because it's very important we get your weight down significantly right now. And we're going to also start you doing physical therapy every day to get your stamina up. Okay. But once we get your weight in the 500s and cardiologist said you're ready, we're going to transfer you to a PT facility that will help to get your stamina up even more. Because your heart is very weak right now, and we have to address that immediately.
Okay.
Because if we don't do it now, you're not gonna survive much longer. And what we need to do to reduce the strain in your heart right now, which is the most important thing. All right, Kelly. I'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
All right, if you need anything, let me know.